Hello everybody, this is Dr. Noor Badshah from University of Engineering and Technology, Peshawar. This is the second lecture in the continuation of lectures on Laplace transforms. In previous lecture, I talked about basic or introduction to Laplace transform. In this video, our main aim will be our main focus will be using some well-known theorems on Laplace transforms. This may mainly jo hamara is lecture mein focus hai wo shifting theorem pe hoga. Okay, so as I said earlier, hum usually Laplace transform ko use karenge for solution of differential equations. So for that purpose, you know, differential equations which contains derivatives, you should know how to find transforms of derivatives. Wherever I use the word transform, I would mean Laplace transform. So Laplace transform of derivatives, how do we do that? How do you find it? Let's suppose we have a function f of t, right? And that function f of t, which is defined for t greater than or equal to 0, and obviously it is an n-time differentiable function, then Laplace transform of its first order derivative is simply f dash t. You see isme hamare paas jo function aayega wo function hoga f of t ke bajaye I'll be using f dash t. You see, aur phir isko integrate karte hain again by using integration by parts. So after doing integration by parts and then putting the limits, you'll get what? That is s Laplace of f of t minus f of 0. Okay, this is the formula which is obtained from this integral. Similarly, if you go for the second order derivatives, okay, so for second order derivative, what do we do? F Laplace of f double dash t, that is s square Laplace of f of t, because yahan par jo function hum use karenge ye double dash ho jayega aur phir isko hum ek bar jab integrate karenge so hamare paas pehle ye wala term aa jayega, theek hai, yahan se aur phir isi ko dobara use karte hue hamare paas kya ho jata hai, we get this one. Okay, and then we can go for third order as well, and there is a sequence in it. You see, starting from s cube, the powers of s are going towards s power 0, whereas the function is started from f Laplace transform, and then we are having f of 0, then f dash 0, and then f double dash 0. You see, if you want to find Laplace transform of third order derivative, so we are having at the end double derivative at t equal to 0. The same can be generalized for nth order derivative as well, right? So Laplace of f n t, which obviously means nth order derivative, that will be s power n. और ये कहाँ से जनरलाइज हो गया, ये हमने ऊपर से ही जनरलाइज कर दिया. जब थर्ड ऑर्डर ड्राइवेटिव था तो हमने एस क्यूब लिया था, सेकेंड ऑर्डर में स्क्वायर लिया था, फर्स्ट ऑर्डर में हमारे पास ये एस आ रहा था. तो अगर nth ऑर्डर ड्राइवेटिव है तो इन दैट केस विल बी टेकिंग एस पावर एन विद लेप्लास ऑफ टी, लेप्लास ऑफ एफ ऑफ टी. देख सकते हैं सब में जो लेप्लास ऑफ एफ ऑफ टी होता है वो स्टार्ट में फिक्स है, फिर इसके बाद जो नेक्स्ट सम आता है वो पावर उससे वन कम हो जाता है और साथ में फंक्शन की वैल्यू ए टी इक्वल टू जीरो आ जाता है. फिर इसके बाद स्टेप बाय स्टेप एस के पावर्स कम होते जा रहे हैं और वहाँ पे ड्राइवेटिव जहाँ बढ़ते जाते हैं, एंड देन वी एंड अप विद एन माइनस वन थर्ड ड्राइवेटिव. जब यहाँ पे थर्ड ऑर्डर था तो ये सेकेंड ऑर्डर पे स्टॉप हो गया, जब यहाँ पे सेकेंड ऑर्डर था तो ये फर्स्ट ऑर्डर पे स्टॉप हो गया. ओके, सो ये हमने यूज़ करने हैं, सॉरी, लेटर ऑन जब हम सॉल्व करेंगे डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशंस को बाय यूजिंग लेप्लास ट्रांसफॉर्म्स. ओके, सो ये जो फार्मूलाज हैं या थियरम्स हैं या रूल्स हैं, इनको हम यूज़ कर सकते हैं फॉर फाइंडिंग लेप्लास ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ फंक्शंस एज वेल, जिसको हम डायरेक्टली फाइंड नहीं कर सकते. लेट मी डू सम एग्जांपल्स. सी, इफ यू वांट टू फाइंड लेप्लास ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ एफ ऑफ टी इज इक्वल टू कॉस स्क्वायर टी, वी हैव ऑलरेडी फाउंड दिस टाइप ऑफ लेप्लास ट्रांसफॉर्म बाई यूजिंग ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक आइडेंटिटी दैट कॉस स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू वन प्लस कॉस टू टी डिवाइडेड बाई टू, right? That was discussed in the previous lecture. And then its Laplace would be what? 1 over 2. Laplace of 1 is simply 1 over s, whereas Laplace of cos 2t will be s divided by s squared plus 4. But let's explain this derivative concept. Okay, what do? We find its derivative first, right? So f dash t, you know that derivative of cos squared will be 2 times cos t into derivative of cos will be minus sine t एंड इस एवरी बडी नोज दैट कि जो 2 cos t sin t है ये बराबर होता है sin 2 t के. राइट, नाउ वी यूज द फार्मूला विच इज गिवन बाय दिस वन, लेप्लास ऑफ एफ डैश टी, दैट इज एस टाइम्स लेप्लास ऑफ एफ ऑफ टी एंड एफ ऑफ जीरो. नाउ यू सी एफ ऑफ जीरो इज 1, सो जस्ट पुट 1 हियर. वी आर हैविंग एस हियर एंड दिस विल बी लेप्लास ऑफ cos स्क्वायर टी, वेयर एज वी आर हैविंग दिस एफ डैश टी साइन 2 टी, एंड यू नो लेप्लास ऑफ साइन 2 टी विल बी 2 डिवाइड बाई एस स्क्वायर प्लस 4. वी मे टेक दिस टू दिस साइड टू मेक इट प्लस एंड देन सिंप्लीफाई इट to get the following expression. You see, putting the value of the Laplace of sine 2t, that will be 2 by s square plus 4 is equal to s into Laplace of cos square t minus 1, and then you simplify this to get Laplace transform of cos square t divided by s on both sides to get s square plus 2 divided by s into s square plus 4. Right, so the same thing can be done by using trigonometric identity. Thoda sa lengthy hai ye wala, lekin sometimes hum wo wala rule apply nahi kar sakte, so we have to go for this technique. Like in this example, the next example I am doing f of t, that is t cos omega t. Yeah, there is another rule for doing this type of Laplace transform, but at this moment you don't know that. Okay, uska hum baad mein directly use karenge. Okay, so how do we do that? See, in this case f of 0 pehle find karte hain, which is 0, and then you find f dash t, and then we have f dash 0 as well. So f dash 0 is 1 because you know cos 0 is 1, we are sin 0 is 0. Lekin ab yahan pe agar aap dekh lein to f dash se hame koi khas fayda nahi hua, because we don't know how to find Laplace transform of cos omega 2 t. Same thing, we don't know Laplace of t sin omega t as well. So we would find f dash 0 here, and then we go for the next one, that is f double dash t. अब f double dash t से हमारे पास फायदा क्या हुआ कि sin omega t तो आ गया, इसका Laplace transform हमें पता है, where as t cos omega t repeat हो गया है. तो इसका मतलब है कि we can use the formula which is for second order one, Laplace of f double dash t is equal to s square Laplace of f of t minus this one. Now we could simply use this formula now. अब सवाल यहाँ पे ये होता है कि क्या हम यहाँ पे first order का use कर सकते हैं? तो द आंसर इज नो, वी कैन नॉट डू दैट, बिकॉज यहाँ पे हमें ये जो टर्म है टी साइन ओमेगा टी जो कि यहाँ पे आने वाला है, उस केस में वो उसकी ड्राइवेटिव लेप्लास मौजूद नहीं है. यहाँ पर भी मौजूद नहीं है, लेकिन ये असल में रिपीट हो रहा है, तो ये इस फंक्शन के साथ जो एफ ऑफ टी का लेप्लास है और ये वाला टर्म अभी हम कंबाइन कर देंगे. Okay, so how do we do that? You see, putting the values of f double dash t, putting the value of f of t, f dash 0 and f 0. F of 0, that is 0. F dash 0 is replaced with 1. You see that the value was found. Or is tarah se Laplace of f of t ko put kar diya, t cos omega t. F double dash t ko bhi right left side pe humne put kar diya hai. Theek hai? Okay, so you see hamare paas ye kya, this is the value of Laplace of f of t. Okay, acha, next kya hai hamare paas? Ab yahan pe wahi linear property ko use kar rahe hain. 2 ओमेगा कांस्टेंट है, तो ये बाहर आ गया लेप्लास ऑफ साइन ओमेगा टी, ओमेगा स्क्वायर यहाँ से बाहर आ जाएगा, और लेप्लास ऑफ टी कॉज ओमेगा टी, दिस इज इक्वल टू एस स्क्वायर लेप्लास ऑफ टी कॉज ओमेगा टी माइनस 1. अब ये दोनों तो हमें मालूम नहीं है, उनको फाइंड करना है, सो वी कैन कंबाइन देम. इसको इधर लेके आ जाओ और 1 को इधर लेके आओ. साइन ओमेगा टी का लेप्लास हमें पता है, दैट इज 2 ओमेगा अपनी जगह पे आ रहा है, और इसका लेप्लास होता है ओमेगा डिवाइड बाई एस स्क्वायर प्लस ओमेगा स्क्वायर, वेयर इज इन दोनों कंबाइन करने के बाद वी गेट एस स्क्वायर प्लस ओमेगा स्क्वायर इंटू लेप्लास ऑफ टी कॉस ओमेगा टी. But we are interested to find Laplace of t cos omega t, so what do? We will be taking LCM on the left side and then dividing both sides by s square plus omega square. So the left side will give you what? That is simply s square plus omega square minus 2 omega square. After simplification, it will give you s square minus omega square. Okay, and then dividing by this one to get Laplace transform of t cos omega t, which is s square minus omega square divided by omega s square plus omega square whole square. And similarly, we can go for t sin omega t as well, which will be done in exactly the same steps. ठीक है, यहाँ से हम शुरू करेंगे और फिर यही चीज़ होगी, दो बार इसका डिफ्रेंशिएट करना है, पुटिंग करेंगे, एंड यू विल गेट द सिमिलर टाइप ऑफ सोल्यूशन या वैल्यू फॉर लेप्लास ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ टी साइन ओमेगा टी. ओके, नाउ वी मूव टूवर्ड्स शिफ्ट, फर्स्ट शिफ्टिंग थ्योरम. दिस इज ऑल्सो नोन एज एस शिफ्टिंग थ्योरम, जिसमें हम शिफ्टिंग करते हैं, ऑब्वियसली यू नो दैट. So how does this state? We say f of, you know that the function f of t has a Laplace transform f of s, and we want to find Laplace transform of e power a t f of t. So without doing anything, you'll simply replace s with s minus a, okay, in the Laplace transform of f of t. So you would find Laplace transform of f of t first, and then replacing s with s minus a, which is depending on the value of this coefficient of a t, sorry, in the exponential. Ab ye shifting hai, you see that we have f of s, which is replaced with s minus a, to hamare paas ye s shifting hai, okay. For example, if you want to find Laplace transform of t cube e power 2t, so first we find Laplace transform of t cube, you see. Laplace transform of t cube, everybody knows that, we have discussed in last lecture. Ye 3 factorial divided by s power 4 ke barabar hai. Ab jo s shifting karenge, jab e power 2t ko multiply kar diya jata hai, to yahan par a ki jagah kya hai? 2 hai. To isme jahan kahin pe bhi s hai, usko hum replace kar dete hain s minus 2 ke saath. Okay, so that become 3 factorial divided by s minus 2 whole power 4. ये अपनी जगह पे आएगा और यहां पर s रिप्लेस हो गया s minus 2 के साथ. Okay, if you want to find Laplace transform of e power at cos omega t, obviously अगर हम इसको find करें किसी और methods तो बड़ा लंबा हो जाएगा, integration अगर हम use करेंगे इसमें, तो we know Laplace of cos omega t, that is s divided by s square plus omega square. In this case, what do we do? Laplace of e power at cos omega t will be what? That will be simply found by replacing s with s minus a everywhere. Okay, so Laplace of e power a t cos omega t, that is equal to s minus a. Ye s minus a kahan se aa raha hai? Is s ko humne replace kar diya s minus a ke saath. Aur ye s minus a bhi wahi hai kyunki yahan pe s square hai, to we are replacing s with s minus a whole square, and then you can find anyone. Okay, what about the inverse Laplace transform in this case? So if we know that f of t is the inverse Laplace transform of f of s, or we say if f of s is the Laplace transform of f of t, then what about Laplace inverse of f of s, which will be f of t? ठीक है, इसको हम इस तरह कह सकते हैं. लेकिन हमारा जो इंटरेस्ट है वो ये है कि अगर हमें चाहिए Laplace inverse of f of s minus a, तो वही चीज यहाँ से आप पहले f of t को फाइंड करोगे और फिर साथ में e power a t को सिंपली मल्टीप्लाई करोगे. सो Laplace इनवर्स ऑफ f of s minus a, दैट विल बी e power a t into f of t. ओके, फॉर एग्जांपल, इफ यू आर्क्ड टू फाइंड Laplace इनवर्स ऑफ 2s plus 5 divided by s minus 3 squared. अब यहां से हमें आइडिया हो रहा है कि ये किस तरह का फंक्शन हमें गिवन है इन टर्म्स ऑफ f. तो आप देख सकते हैं इट इज s minus 3, सो वी विल बी कंसीडरिंग दिस is a fs minus 3. Okay, so this is f of s minus 3. Achha, f of s minus 3 se pehle hame f of s chahiye, because hame pehle pata hona chahiye f of s ka Laplace inverse kya hai. To isme kya karenge, jab f of s minus 3 se hum f of s ki taraf jayenge, to yahan par jahan kahin pe bhi s hai, usko replace karoge kiske sath? S plus 3 ke saath. To humne yahan par s plus 3 se replace kiya, is jagah se bhi, and when simplify that, these three to cancel, we get 2s plus 6 plus 5, which give you 11, aur phir dono ko humne divide kar diya s square ke saath. Idhar se bhi aa gaya, idhar se bhi aa gaya. So we have f of s equal to 2 by s plus 11 by s square. Ye hame pata chal gaya hai, upar wala ye. This one. Ab hum yahan se f of t find karenge, okay? Now this f of t can be simply found, because 2 by s Laplace transform basically means 2. 11 by s square means 11t. Now this is the Laplace inverse of this quantity. Lekin hame to iski chahiye, upar jo given hai, hame iski chahiye. Okay, to usko ke liye kya karna hoga? Saath mein e power at aapne define karna hai. Ab a kya hai yahan par? Wo yahan se humne determine kiya tha. A is equal to 3. To baaki same rahega. Sirf hum yun kar lenge ke ye jo 2 plus 11t hai, iske saath e power 3t laga lenge. इसमें मेन जो पॉइंट है वो ये है, स्टेप्स ये हैं कि पहले जो भी आपको लैप्लास ट्रांसफॉर्म दिया हुआ है, जो फंक्शन दिया हुआ है, उसको आपने f ऑफ s माइनस a के बराबर लेना है, और वो a यहां से हम डिटरमिन कर सकते हैं. ठीक है, इधर से नहीं कर सकते. समटाइम्स वी कैन नॉट डू दैट. तो यूजुअली हम यहां से इसको डिटरमिन करते हैं. ठीक है, वंस वी हैव फाउंड दैट f ऑफ s माइनस a, वहाँ से एफ ऑफ एस को फाइंड करोगे, फिर उसका लेप्लास इनवर्स फाइंड करोगे और आखिर में फिर वही ई पावर ए टी साथ में मल्टीप्लाई करोगे। अच्छा, इफ यू रिमेंबर, अगर आपने लास्ट वीडियो देखी है तो उसमें मैं डिस्कस किया था कि इफ़ यू हैव पीस वाइज डिफाइंड फंक्शंस आर स्टेप फंक्शंस, तो कैन वी एक्सप्रेस दैट एज अ वन फंक्शन एंड यूजिंग दैट यूनिट स्टेप फंक्शन। ओके, सो फर्स्ट वी डिफाइन व्हाट इज यूनिट स्टेप फंक्शन, राइट? इट्स ऑब्वियसली यूजुअली वी डिनोट दैट बाय यू टी माइनस ए एंड दैट इज डिफाइंड एज its value will be 0 when t is between 0 and a, and its value will be 1 when t is greater than or equal to a, right? And then we define every function in terms of this one. We may call this unit step function as well, matlab a function with one step, right? A piecewise defined function as well, right? So can we express a piecewise defined function in terms of ut minus a in terms of unit step function? The answer is yes, we can do. So what is the process of that? Because once you convert this piecewise defined function into a unit step function, then we could find its Laplace transform easily. Okay, so how do you do that? The steps are, first, let's suppose we are given a function f of t that is equal to g of t when t is between a and b, and it is h of t when it is between b and c. Okay, the procedure is, when you want to express this one in terms of ut minus a and ut minus b, so how do you do that? Dekhen, aapke paas ye jo interval given hai hame, this interval from a to b, this one, to aap aise karenge, is function ko uta le, take this function and multiplied by the difference of unit step functions at this position, like ut minus a, right, minus ut minus b, aur phir second function ko utha ke unke sath multiply karen, the difference of ut minus b and ut minus c, can function ye wala multiply hoga sath mein. That's the procedure to convert a piecewise defined function in terms of unit step function. Okay, for example, I'll do that example in a while. Okay, second shifting theorem, which is also known as T shifting theorem, previously was known as, the first shifting theorem was also known as S shifting theorem, right? This is T shifting theorem, because in this case the T will be shifted accordingly. So if a function f of t that has a Laplace transform f of s, and we want to find Laplace transform of f of t minus a u t minus a, that will be e power minus a s into f of s, keeping in mind a will be greater than 0, and that's clear from unit step function, because u t minus a, that means value 0 when t is less than a, and so on. So a must be greater than or equal to 0. Okay, for example, if you want to find Laplace transform of ut minus a, तो इसके साथ यहाँ पे जो multiply हो रहा है वो यहाँ पे 1 मौजूद है, तो Laplace transform of 1 जिसको हम f of s कह रहे हैं, ये 1 over s हो जाएगा, और साथ में फिर accordingly e power minus a s multiply करना है. Okay, right, so in similar way, अगर हम inverse find करेंगे in every theorem or in every rule, what do we do? We need to have a direct formula and we need to have a inverse as well. So if we have you see somewhere e power minus s a s multiplied by a function of s, to uske liye lazim baat hai ki hum kya karenge, second shifting theorem ko use karenge. Okay, and obviously apne f of t find karna hai from Laplace inverse of f of s. Okay, ji. So let's suppose we want to find Laplace transform of a function which is defined in this graph, which is saying when x is, when t is between 0, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, and onward. So if it is between 1 and 2, 0 and 1, sorry, the value is 2. When it is between 2 and 3, the value is minus 1, you see, right? And later on, its value is what? That is 0. Previously, we have found the Laplace transform of this type of function by using integration, जो कि काफ़ी लंबा चौड़ा हो रहा था. अब हम यहाँ पे यूनिट स्टेप फंक्शन को यूज़ करेंगे और वहाँ से Laplace transform को आसानी से फाइंड करेंगे. तो फर्स्ट वी राइट दिस फंक्शन the function, corresponding function to the graph of this one, which is 2 when t is between 0 and 2. It is minus 1 when it is between 2 and 3. It is 0 when t is greater than or equal to 3. The first step is we need to convert this function into a piecewise, unit step function. And how do we do that? So, as I explained earlier, you will take 2 first multiplied by ut minus 2, ut and ut minus 2, the difference of them. Then we have minus 1 ut minus 2. Isme hum kya karenge? Lower limit pe unit step function ko define karo aur upper limit pe define karo. So, lower minus upper pe karna hai multiplied by the corresponding function value. Then we have ut minus 2 minus ut minus 3 multiplied by the corresponding function minus 1. And then we have 0 for the rest of this. Agar ye 0 na hota, let's suppose agar ye 4 hota, 5 hota, t hota, whatever it would have been. Okay. To yahan par ek to aur term bhi saath mein aa jata aur hum kehte hain bhai this is plus t aur saath mein likhte ut minus 3. Lekin yahan par asal mein ye 0 hai, to hum yahan pe kya kar rahe hain? Iske saath 0 likh rahe hain. To 0 is making everything 0. Okay, so this is the way to convert it. Ab acha Laplace ko find karna hai iska, to dono side pe Laplace transform apply karenge after simplifying this. So Laplace of f of t is Laplace of 2 minus 3 times Laplace of ut minus 2 plus Laplace of ut minus 3. To abhi thode pehle humne kiya tha ki Laplace transform of ut minus a, that is 1 over s into e power minus as. So, here 2 constant, hai, so its Laplace will be simply 2 by s, you know that. Okay. Here, what will 3 by s into e power minus 2s, because this 3 we can nikal sakte hain due to linearity. Or Laplace of ut minus 3, that is e power minus 3s divided by s, which might be simplified as well. You can take 1 over s common. Okay, next we want to find Laplace inverse of this function. So how do we do that? To find Laplace inverse of this function, we first define f of s here. So in this case, our f of s will be this function. Anything jo ke e power minus a s ke saath multiply ho raha hai, usko hum f of s kahenge. To f of s hamare paas barabar hai kiske? S square plus 9 ke barabar hai. Kya hum yahan se f of t ko find kar sakte hain? The answer is yes. That is Laplace inverse of s by s square plus 9. Which is cos 3t. Okay, so as an example, I've done that. So you see Laplace inverse of s by s square plus 9 is cos 3t, which will be called as f of t. And then by using second shifting theorem, Laplace inverse of e power minus a s f of s, that is equal to f of t minus a u t minus a. Dhyan mein rakh lein ki yahan par jo a ki value hai, wo minus pi by 2 hai. See, this is e power minus as, so we are having what? This is our a. So matlab kya hua, agar hum ye find karenge, to f of t was found as cos 3 t minus pi by 2 into ut minus pi by 2. Okay, that's what we will be having, cos 3 into t minus pi by 2 u t minus pi by 2, because in this case a is what? That is pi by 2. Just come further simplify bhi kar sakte hain. You simple multiply 3 inside, so we get cos 3t minus 3 pi by 2 ut minus pi by 2. And then applying cos alpha minus beta formula, okay? So we have cos 3t sin 3 pi by 2 is 0, and then we have sin 3t sin 3 pi by 2 is minus 1. So we have minus sin 3t ut minus pi by 2. Just compare again piecewise defined function ke form mein bhi likh sakte hain. If you don't want to have unit step function in the solution, so you can simply have ut minus pi by 2 is 0 when t is less than pi by 2, and its value will be 1 when t is greater than pi by 2. Okay, now let's do some practice questions. Okay, so we want to find Laplace transform of this function. You see, we know Laplace transform of t that was found is 1 over s square by using first shifting theorem. Laplace transform of e power minus 2t into t will be 1 divided by s plus 2 whole square. because f of s was found as 1 over s square और यहाँ पर a की जगह क्या है ये minus 2 है so a is equal to minus 2 Similarly for the next one, we have t minus 1 whole square into t power 2. So first we find Laplace transform of this function t minus 1 whole square. So you know Laplace transform of t minus 1 whole square, which is Laplace transform of t square minus 2t plus 1, which will be 2 divided by s cube minus 2 divided by s square plus 1 divided by s, right? But using first shifting theorem, you need to multiply that with what? We have e power 2t, so shifting this will be giving your required Laplace transform. So e power 2t into t minus 1 square will be 2 divided by s minus 2 cube. 2 divided by s minus 2 square plus 1 divided by s minus 2 because yahan par hamare paas jo a hai wo 2 ke barabar hai so f of s minus a will give you required result next one is e power t sine 3t now you see it's again a lengthy process I want to use that integration so first we find Laplace of sine 3t that is 3 divided by s square plus 9 by the first shifting theorem Laplace of e power t sine 3t that will be 3 divided by s square proper tarika iska yahi hai aur yahan pe hum likh lenge ki replacing s with s minus 3 so we could write that as 3 divided by s minus 3 sorry it's 1 not 3 at s goes to 1 this is s minus 1 square plus 9 which might be simplified as 3 divided by s square minus 2s plus 1 plus 9 or we could write that as 3 divided by s square minus 2s plus 10 Similarly, we do some more questions. First, you would find Laplace transform of this function. Okay. Or first, we find this one. So, we would find first this one. Then, by taking with 1 with e power minus t. Or, isko hum aise kar dein pehle. Cos 5t. E power minus t cos 5t. Plus 3 times e power minus 4t cos 5t. So we first find cos 5t's Laplace. So Laplace of cos 5t that is s divided by s square plus 25. So Laplace of this given function f of t will be what? Yahan pe to simple aa jayega s divided by s square plus 25. Minus s divided by s square plus 25 but replacing s with s plus 1 because yahan pe hamare paas ye kya hai minus t hai to a ki value minus 1 hai plus 3 s divided by s square plus 25 lekin yahan par hum s ko replace karenge s plus 4 ke sath so all together we have s by s square plus 25 minus s plus 1 divided by s plus 1 square plus 25 plus 3 times s plus 4 divided by s plus 4 square plus 25 which might be simplified if you open this square and then multiplying by 3 inside etc. Okay so the same thing here अगर यहाँ पे थोड़ा सा उसका ट्रांसफर सेटअप है यहाँ पे इसका हम पहले लैपलास फाइंड करेंगे और इसके बाद फिर साथ में हर जगह पे रिप्लेस करेंगे एस को एस माइनस थ्री के साथ सो वी फर्स्ट फाइंड लैपलास ऑफ 9 माइनस 4 टी प्लस 10 टाइम्स साइन टी बाई 2 So this will be Laplace of 9, it's a constant, so it will be 9 by s. Minus 4 times, it will be 1 by s squared. Plus 10 times, this will be 1 over 2 divided by s squared plus 1 by 4. Because sine omega t Laplace is what? That is omega divided by s squared plus omega squared. So Laplace of f of t will be then, अब देखिए यहाँ पर क्या हो रहा है सबके साथ हमारे पास e power 3t multiply हो रहा है. It means it is 9 by s, 4 by s square, 5 by s square plus 1 by 4 with s going to s minus 3. So altogether we'll be having 9 divided by s minus 3, 4 divided by s minus 3 square, plus 5 divided by s minus 3 square, plus 1 by 4. This is the Laplace transform of 9 minus 4t plus 10 sine t e power 3t. Okay, so let's talk about some inverse Laplace transforms. In this case, we say find f of t if Laplace of f is given as f of s, okay? So let's suppose we are given f of s that is equal to 1 over s minus 1 power 4. So this is basically what? This is the value of f of s minus 1. Keeping in mind, एक ये एफ ऑफ एस है दूसरा ये एफ ऑफ एस है तो और सम डिफरेंट यूज करते हैं लेट मी यूज जी ऑफ एस डजंट मैटर सो इन दिस केस इट इज जी ऑफ एस माइनस वन विच इज वन ओवर एस माइनस वन पावर फोर यहां से पहले हम क्या करेंगे जी ऑफ एस को फाइंड करेंगे सो जी ऑफ एस विल बी वन ओवर एस प्लस वन माइनस वन पावर फोर यानी यहां पे जब एस माइनस वन है और इधर से हम s बनाना चाहेंगे तो s को रिप्लेस करना पड़ेगा s प्लस 1 के साथ तो दैट इज गिविंग यू व्हाट 1 ओवर s पावर 4 जिसको हम थोड़ा सिंपलीफाई कर देते हैं 1 बाई 3 फैक्टोरियल इंटू 3 फैक्टोरियल डिवाइडेड बाय s पावर 3 प्लस 1 सो g ऑफ t विच इज द लेप्लास इनवर्स ऑफ g ऑफ s And that will give you 1 by 3 factorial into t cube. So by using first shifting theorem, Laplace inverse of f of s, which is obviously e power a t into g of t. Keeping in mind in this case, a is equal to what? A is equal to 1. So that is e power t, or saath mein aa jayega t cube. By 3 factorial. So this is the Laplace transform of 1 over s minus 1 power 4. Okay, again, the next question is f of s equal to 2s plus 5 divided by s square plus 6s plus 34. अच्छा अब इसमें अगर आप देख लें तो यहाँ पे हमें कोई खास आइडिया नहीं हो रहा कि हमें g of s क्या गिवन है तो वी मे सिंप्लीफाई दिस अ बिट 2s plus 5 divided by I do completing square so s square plus 6s plus 9 plus 25 which might be written as 2s plus 5 divided by s plus 3 square plus 25 now from here we can have some idea ke ye jo given function hai ye basically gs plus 3 hai यहाँ पर a की जो वैल्यू आ रही है फर्स्ट शिफ्टिंग थ्योरम में वो माइनस 3 है तो जी एस प्लस 3 दैट इज गिवन एज 2s प्लस 5 डिवाइडेड बाय s प्लस 3 होल स्क्वायर प्लस 25 नाउ व्हाट वुड वी डू वी सिंपली नीड टू फाइंड g ऑफ s फ्रॉम हियर सो g ऑफ s विल बी 2 इंटू एस माइनस 3 प्लस 5 Yeah.